Step 6. Ligation. During the ligation step, we are going to mix the linearized vector and the insert together and add a T4 DNA ligase that will fuse their ends, forming a circular plasmid. Let's set up the ligation reaction. Here on the bench I have double distilled water, a tube with cut vector, a tube with cut insert, an aliquot of ligase buffer. Remember that ligase buffer has to be aliquoted to avoid freeze thawing, an empty tube for vector plus insert, an empty tube for control, and the T4 DNA ligase. I'm going to set up two reactions, one with vector and insert, and one with vector alone for control. In the vector plus insert tube, I'm going to combine 9 microliters of water, 2 microliters of cut vector, six microliters of cut insert, two microliters of the ligase buffer, and 1 microliter of DNA ligase. And as always, I mix it up and down with a pipe. The control tube is pretty much identical, the only difference is that it contains water instead of insert. In the control tube I'm going to put 15 microliters of water, it's 9 plus 6 instead of insert, two microliters of cut vector, two microliters of ligase buffer, we are skipping the insert here, and 1 microliter of T4 DNA ligase. And the mixing step. Now I'm going to split the contents of the ligation tubes into two aliquots. Here I have two new tubes. One of them I will label as vector plus insert, Another one is vector control. And I will transfer 10 microliters from each of the ligation tubes into its replica. I'm going to leave the first set of tubes on the bench for 15-minute room temperature ligation. And I will put the other set of tubes in a 16-degree incubator overnight. If tomorrow I will not get any colonies from the 15-minute ligation, I will repeat the transformation step with the tubes I kept at 16 degrees overnight.